cute human. Wait for me. I want to talk. Jeez, where are you headed in such a hurry? What, it hurt you to slow down and enjoy the view? What's the point in rushing through life anyway? Don't you want to take your time and enjoy the pretty mountain sights? Hey, watch out. Train is dangerous at that speed. Watch your step. Finally caught up with you. To think it would take you almost falling to your death for me to catch up with you. You don't waste any time, though. You could have slowed down a little. Hey, are you listening to me? Human. Human. Cute human. Leave you alone? But why? Don't you want company? It's lonely up here on the mountain. And that bag you're carrying looks really heavy. Let me help you carry it. Come here. Come here. Don't worry about it. This bag is nothing for me. And now that I'm carrying it, you have no choice but to stay with me. I bet you didn't see that one coming. Now, my new human friend, let's walk together. Huh, now that I think of it, where are we walking? There's nothing up this mountain, you know. Once you go back down, it just goes out to the sea. Don't tell me you're going to leave on a boat. Is there a rafting spot? How would that even work? Curious indeed. You're just going to the top of the mountain? But why? Hiking? What's hiking? It's when you walk up mountains for fun. And then go back down where you came from. I suppose I can understand the walking part. Wandering, enjoying nature, but the returning, I don't like to stay in one place, you know. Always moving forward, never looking back. That's just the kind of person I am. So, I can't imagine wanting to walk forward only to retrace your own steps the next day. What's the point? I suppose that means you have a home to return to. Oh, I wonder what it's like. Humans are always cooped up in their little boxes. Birds don't like to be caged, you know. That applies to harpies like me, too, so. A house? I suppose it would be alright to stay there for a few days, but after that I would start getting antsy. You too. And that's why I have to leave to go. I think I'm starting to understand. Maybe we have more in common than I thought. But there's still one more mystery to be solved. Why were you so rude to me when I first met you? I'm sure you heard me shouting, "Hey, hey, human, cute human." And yet, I was completely ignored. Dun dun dun. How disappointing. But you seem friendly enough now that I've grabbed through your tough exterior. heal. You've heard rumors? Rumors of Harpy. What have you heard? I'm curious. That we devour helpless travelers? On small mammals, like, you know, mice and deer, goats, sheep, you know, not humans. Well, if that's what you thought of Harpy, then I suppose your trepidation makes sense. Still, you came around quickly. What, did you think I was too friendly to eat you? You might be right. Humans make great conversational partners. It's not too often that I run into them, though. I tend to attract birds instead. You know what they say about bird brain? Yeah. Not the most stimulating conversations. But you are stimulating. So, what do you say? Wanna be friends? Yay! How exciting! My first human friend. So, friend, you're climbing up this mountain, and when you get to the top, you're going to sleep in a tent, and the next day, you're going to climb right back down and go home. Did I get all that right? I see. So, what's home like? Do you live with anyone? So that's how it is. Hey, friend. Can I come back to your home with you? Don't I know what I'm asking? What? Do friends not visit one another in their homes? Yeah, but it's not like that. Then why? We're friends, aren't we? We only just met. Well, yeah, but you trust me, right? That's not the problem. Just when I thought I was finally starting. You're going to have to explain things to me a little better. I'm kind of dense, you know? Well, I suppose my bones are very light, but my head... let's just say that human customs are a mystery to me. Bird brain and all, you know? And you're nervous? Why would you be nervous about taking me home? Don't tell me you believe the myth that harpies can't control their bladders. I won't pee on your carpet, I promise. Ugh. All these misconceptions. Maybe if you get to know me a little better, you won't be so nervous. I promise I'm well behaved. I won't even claw your furniture. And I'll vacuum up all my feathers. It's not that. Then what? It's starting to feel like you just don't like me. Is that it? No? You just think I'm cute? Of course you do. I'm cutest, fluffiest harpy ever was. It's no reason to make you nervous. Of course it is. But you're pretty cute too, and I'm not nervous at all. Hey. You got all quiet. Am I really that intimidating? Another mystery to be solved. Human behavior is indeed very perplexing. Lou, you have any snacks in here? Getting kinda hungry. Why don't I just catch a mouse or something? Yeah, I could, but humans usually have tasty snacks. Let me put it this way. Would you rather eat a raw rat or some snacks? Just because I have bird brain doesn't mean I have bird taste buds. I'm part human too. Meat is delicious, but only when it's cooked properly. And we don't have time for that when we have a mountaintop to see. Hey, what's this? Jerky. It's dry, like leather. Do you really eat this? Try it. Oh, chewy! Delicious! Where did you find this? It's meat! So yummy! This is the best day ever. Hey, do you have any more? That was it? Really? You have more at home? Does that mean? Really? I can come home with you? Yes. Best day ever. I knew tracking your scent was a good idea. Happy harpy. Hey, we're getting close to the top now, right? Just before sunset, too. I guess you planned the timing, huh? Humans sure will go through a lot of trouble for a nice view of the sunset. Maybe I take flying for granted. There's no better view of the sky than... well, the sky. The top of a mountain is a close second. And then we can set up our tent, and tomorrow we can go to your house and eat jerky. This is it. The peak of the mountain. We reached the tippy top. Are your feet tired? Mine are. I'm not used to walking so much. If it weren't for you, I would have flown my way up here. But I didn't want you to be lonely on the ground. Here, let's sit. You got some blankets in here, right? Rather not sit on the dirt. Well, I wouldn't really mind. Your blanket might be more comfortable. Whoosh! There we go. Now, sit with me. We can watch the sunset from here. How does it feel? Making it to the top. Do you feel accomplished? Like you've climbed a mountain? Overcome a rocky foe? Against all odds, with only an odd heartbeat at your side. I think you should be proud of yourself. But it's not the first time you've climbed this mountain. Why should that matter? Are you only allowed to be proud of something the first time you did it? Climbing a mountain is still an accomplishment, regardless of how many times you've done it. Look at it this way. If a painter finishes a piece they worked really hard on, that's an accomplishment. Even if they've painted hundreds of masterpieces already, right? So, don't be afraid. Pat yourself on the back, even for the little things. Cleaned your room? Accomplishment. Ate a healthy dinner? Accomplishment. Climbed a mountain? Accomplishment. Do you get enough?
Jerky. Yes, this
especially for jerky. You'll have to go cold. I'm just kidding. You don't mind sharing, right? Yeah, of course not. That's better. Get out of here, cold wind. Jerky? I'm not sure. I think I'll need to sample some more before I make my final call. You have some in your home, right? Yes, I'm still thinking about that. I want to see what your life is like. If the blankets you packed with you are this comfortable, your home must be even comfier. You're not worried about me coming back with you, are you? I'll be a good little birdie, I promise. Just as long as you let me eat all your dirt. Under water pretend to sleep now. Good night. No, no. Take me back to your home tomorrow, okay? I'm going to eat.